Now, before I even get started with this video, I just want to say RIP to the homie Pop Smoke, going way too soon. His career was taking off, and it's just so unfortunate, man. So, like, unexpectedly, and it's crazy. So, RIP to Pop Smoke. And also, I opened up my website, so if you guys want to browse around my website, go to shopsimplypops.com. You're going to find my merch. I am putting up this merch right here, so the culture is not for sale. I have the Always Home text on the back. You can buy this Always Home beanie. So Shop Simply Pops is more than just a shopping website. It's also a reviewing website too as well. You can pick up some free wallpapers. So without further ado, let's just get right into the Apple news. I just want to say those two things before I even get started. So we all know Apple is holding an event in March. We just didn't know when or if they're going to skip this year and go straight to WWDC. But there's some leaks and rumors going around saying that on March 31st, that's the day that Apple is going to, you know, announce new products. So the new iPhone SE 2 or the iPhone 9, iPad. We're going to talk more about that in a little bit. But that day, March 31st, is such a crappy day too, because last year, March 31st, you guys know, shout out to everybody, that's the day that Nipsey Hussle passed away. And I feel like that's just such a crappy way to hold an event. But just having some respect for Nipsey Hussle, let's just let his day rock out. I mean, I know he passed away, but let's make that day clear. It's a Nipsey Hussle day, man. It's not supposed to be an Apple day. That's how I feel about that day. And that was the same day that I went to LA too. Last year I went to LA, went the same time that Nipsey Hussle passed away. I'm gonna talk about that in a different video, not this video. But anyway, March 31st is looking likely that Apple is gonna hold an event. All right, so the anticipated iPhone, we've been talking about this for a long period of time, the iPhone SE 2. So we all know the iPhone SE 2 or the iPhone 9 is gonna feature the A13 chip. It's gonna be just as powerful as the iPhone 11, iPhone 11 Pro, Pro Max. It's gonna feature the same iPhone 8 body and design. It's gonna feature the iPhone XR or XR, as the kids call it. It's gonna have that same camera setup, so the single lens, maybe the same front-facing camera too. And it's also gonna feature a 4.7-inch display, so that is pretty small in today's standards, but you're not gonna have a problem holding that phone with one hand, so it's gonna be more comfortable to hold. And it's set to be released on April 3rd, 2020. At the price of $399. So $400 for the iPhone 9 or SE 2. Honestly, let me know down in the comments down below how you guys feel about the name. They all kind of silly in my opinion, but we all thought the iPhone SE was kind of silly too. But hey, we rocked out with it, and that's the name that Apple rocked out with. The iPhone 9 or SE 2 is nothing exciting. It's just taking the iPhone 8 body and putting in the iPhone 11 internal. So it's a possibility that we can use night mode on the iPhone SE, which is pretty cool because it has the A13 chip and the iPhone XR camera or the XR camera. So it's going to be a fairly capable iPhone. So that's going to be the best value for your money. And we all know Apple is going to support that phone for a long period of time. Even the iPhone SE is still being supported to this day by Apple. And that's one of the main reasons why people go with iPhone. You have that lifetime support, and it's the best value for your money. So moving right along to the iPad Pro 2020. So definitely 100% sure that we will see an iPad Pro this year. It's a good chance. So Apple is leaning towards fall, but then there's some leaks and rumors saying that Apple is going to release it in March next month. So I think they're going to release it in fall just because of the 5G technology. It just makes sense that Apple would release 5G on the iPhone first and then on the iPad. And then even with the processor, are they going to put in the A13X chip or the A14X chip? We don't know yet. The 2018 iPad Pro is such ahead of its time that Apple, it's like, what can you really do with the 2018 iPad Pro other than just increasing the processor, putting an extra camera lens, two camera lens on there? It's just like, it's nothing much that they can really do. I wouldn't be surprised they even skip out this year and hold out for 2021, but I think they're going to refresh it because now we get into that iPad Pro window. Now it's time. But the iPad 2018 is so good. And if you're on the fence of buying one, I would say get it, jump the gun and get one because you can pick them up at a fairly good deal. I picked up the 256 cellular version of the iPad Pro 2018 at $679. This is pre-owned. It didn't come with the box, nothing like that, but it's in flawless condition and I don't have no complaints with it at all. I did pick up the Apple Pencil just the other day and I absolutely love my iPad Pro than ever before. Honestly, I don't think it's worth upgrading if you have the 2018 iPad Pro, but if you have the first generation iPad Pro, then this is your time to shine. So the new iPad Pro is going to feature 5G. Now, I think Apple may even increase the size of the 11-inch iPad to 12 inches. That would be really cool. There's some buzz going around with that. So yeah, and also you got to think about it. The price is probably going to go up if you pick up the 5G version. Yeah, if they increase the size of the 11-inch, that's pretty cool too. But I hope they keep the price the same. The iPad Pros are pretty expensive now, so having that even more expensive, that's gonna be pretty tough. And then you still gotta buy the Apple Pencil, you still gotta buy a keyboard, you'd even buy a screen protector or Apple Care. So the iPads are pretty expensive, but they're fun to use. So what can I say? So nothing really too interesting about the iPads. We might see it at the WWDC event in June or maybe the iPhone event in September, but we don't know. I don't think they're going to release it in March. I don't think so. AirTag. Now, AirTag has been rumored and leaked so many times. It's been leaked on the iOS 13 software. So this is definitely coming out next month. So they're going to announce it. They're going to showcase it. They're going to compete with Tal. So you're never going to lose your valuables again. So if you put the AirTag in your wallet, you could track your wallet. So if you misplace it, you could see it on your map, on your iPhone or iPad. And then even better yet, it's going to utilize the U1 chip on your iPhone even better. So yeah, we're going to talk more about that in a little bit. I'm curious to see how Apple is going to put their spin to it. Now, moving on to MacBooks, I believe Apple is going to eventually refresh the MacBook Pro 13-inch. They're going to get the same treatment as the 15-inch model. So the 15-inch turned into a 16-inch, shrinking down the bezels. You're no longer forced to get the 16-inch in order to have a better keyboard or the thinner bezels. So Apple is going to do that to the 14-inch. Even though I think it would have made sense to do it all in one time when they refresh it the first time, but I guess better late than never. And I truly believe Apple is going to come out with some brand new Apple Watch bands. Apple could potentially release iOS 13.4 to the public during this event, showcasing Apple Car Key, so you never have to use your key to unlock your door. So it's going to use your iPhone's NFC reader to unlock your car door. So you can authenticate with Face ID or Touch ID to unlock your doors or start the engine of your car. So this is going to be pretty amazing. I'm not sure how the compatibility is going to work. Maybe if your car supports Apple CarPlay, maybe that would work. I'm curious to see how the setup is going to be. Make sure you guys subscribe if you guys want to see how Car Key is showcased. Of course, I'm going to make a video talking about that. And of course, it's going to utilize the U1 chip that is found on your iPhone 11, iPhone 11 Pro, Pro Max. The U1 chip is such a useful chip on the iPhones, but it's not utilized properly by Apple. So I think this is a perfect way to utilize the U1 chip and also the NFC chip on your iPhone. Now there's some talk and some buzz going around that Apple is going to release AirPods Pro Lite. You guys already know how I feel about AirPods Pro already. This is the light version. This is the skin and bones, the base one. But it turns out to be the AirPods 3. So the AirPods 2 recently got refreshed last year. I said recently. Why did I say recently? It got refreshed last year. It was a site refreshed. It only featured wireless charge, Siri support, maybe faster pairing to different devices. But for the most part, it wasn't really worth an upgrade if you have the first generation AirPods. It's going to be releasing along with the iPhone SE 2 or the iPhone 9. So yeah, so maybe this AirPods 3, Apple's going to showcase the features or maybe do a site refresh, but we don't know what feature is going to be on the AirPods 3. Now, what can they do with the third generation AirPods, the regular AirPods? I would say increase the sound quality, you know, better bass, better treble, better mids, faster pairing, of course, better battery life. Definitely need that. Maybe make the stem a little smaller, make it a little smaller because the regular AirPods stem looks so big inside your ear that I think now we at that point where we can make the stem a little smaller.
Here than the iPhone 11 Pro series, and that's why this could be legit. Squared off design that the iPhone 12 is supposed to adopt according to rumors. Now, one interesting detail I noticed is that on the 6.7 inch, looking at the flash, it appears that it might be a ring type flash, where the flash might encircle a feature. Balked at the design of this, that it was too large.
Now, very quickly talking about the iPhone 12, we have someone who uploaded a video holding the iPhone 12 3D model. It's not the real deal, it's just to see how it looks in action, and it looks pretty authentic. I mean, the camera lens on the back looks bigger. That's normal, that's according to the leaks. Also, you have a ring flash. This is new. I'm not sure if Apple is going to do it, but Apple been playing around with the idea. Remember the first leaks and rumors of the iPhone 12? We were supposed to get a ring flash, but it didn't happen. The iPhone 12 will be thick. It's going to definitely be thicker than the iPhone 11, but that's not a bad thing, though. It's definitely a good thing because that's going to be more room for the battery, more room for tech. So yeah, I appreciate this trend that Apple is doing. They want to improve the battery life, and we all know 5G is coming to the iPhone 12, so Apple is going to ditch Qualcomm and make their own separate 5G chip. So the reason why they're ditching Qualcomm of the 5G chip is because the chip looked a little bulky, a little too bulky for them, so they decided to make their very own. This is Apple's first gen 5G chip, so we got to wait and see how it's going to perform. But we all know how Apple is going to do with their chips, man. It's always of efficiency, high performance. And also, due to the Canelia virus, the iPhone 12 may be delayed up to a month. Now, this is a regular thing. If you remember the iPhone X's release, that was a month later after the iPhone 8 released. So this is a regular thing. That's just something to keep in mind of. It's just like, it is getting terrible, it's getting bad, and I don't know what to say with the Canelia virus. It's just, wash your hands, be protective, be smart, and you'll be okay. But anyway, all the renders and videos that you guys are seeing during the background, that's buy everything Apple Pro. His cases is coming out tomorrow. I'm definitely going to be pre-ordering a case. I'm going to be reviewing it on this channel to see if it's worth the hype or not. We're going to check it out together. So shout out to everything Apple Pro. He's doing it big, making his own cases. He's getting ready to hit 8 million subscribers. He's living a YouTube dream, man. Alright guys, that pretty much concludes today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you guys did, I appreciate it with a thumbs up. Make sure you guys subscribe with notifications on and comment down below what you guys think about the future of Apple. Are they going to release the iPad Pro in fall or spring, or I don't know. Let me know down in the comments down below what you guys think. And also, make sure you guys visit my website. It's always appreciated. A lot of hard work. More merch is coming up. You guys are going to find some wallpapers there. It just feels good to have a website. And also, most importantly, have a simple day. Peace. Now, if you excuse me, I'm going to get some pizza. I'm starving right now. I can eat my own hand right now. I can eat my own hand.